So he's having a look, saw all the houses and the damage. Went to the two schools, the primary school and the secondary school.
Not very good one. Coming now, village.
Well, thank you for having us.
One thing, no food to prepare. Yes, we be gathering in the village. So you've done the Fijian way of sharing the mixtures, eh?
No, no. It's okay. Let me get some water, eh? Need some water here.
Yes.
Why, why?
No, no, no. We'll get, we have to get water for the village.
Ah. Oh.
One of our first priorities to get this done before we organize the village for the village cleanup.
Yeah. First you have to come here. Well, you want me to be good, you come first. Government come in our village. Before it's not like this.
Yeah.
After 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 months, it become home. But it's very good. Excuse my English, not.
No. Excuse me, my Bowen dialect is very good. No, so there's a lot of the power lines have fallen down, the power lines, so they have to fix that up. A lot of the wires fell down,
yeah.
A lot of the posts too fell down. So the main thing is power and the water.
And the solar to you and the solar in this village.
Yeah. So they've opened up the road so the boats can start coming to Nambu.
Can you see another solar to this village?
Sure. We look into that differently. We look into that.
Not.
I saw somebody in one house, they had a solar panel.
Eh? Yeah, yeah. It was a Matangali project.
Okay.
So they had to, they had members of the Matangali to.
There's one house.
A few Matangali were member of.
Just a few houses.
Yeah.
Okay. But this one is all, right? Only one pen and one paper. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, please excuse us. We have to go to some other place.
Naka.
Thank you for having us.
Naka.
A pleasure meeting you. Naka. Thank you.
Naka. Naka.
This house. This corner went down. Look here, everyone. Okay.
Oh! Mr. Attorney General.
Well, how are you?
Fine, thank you. And you? Thank you very much. Glad to meet you today.
With the head of UN.
Have you had?
Hola.
Pleased to meet you, sir.
Very nice to meet you.
Jim Wallah,
Minister. Mr. Waterways.
Yes, I was in the Excellency Division too.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. I'm Jimmy Wallah.
Yeah. Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Where did you go and do your shopping?
From Nakanulu.
Okay.
German station.
Okay.
The one you're talking about, eh?
Yeah. Thank you very much, sir, for coming. No problem. Lucky, nobody injured. Nobody taking his life. Yeah. We're all happy. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Have a nice day.
Thank you too.
Bula, bula.
Bula. Oh, bula.
That obviously has been damaged. Many people hearing, you know, what are their needs, what are the areas of strength that they have. There are obviously some places where all they want is water. Same places want water and also, you know, access to, for example, things like tarpaulins. And then there are some people, of course, who are going to stay in the evacuation centers for a little while longer. But the idea is to meet up with them and hear from them what are the issues. Of course, there's also a rebuild that's necessary, in particular for the schools. We have the team here from the Construction Implementation Unit to assess the extent of the damage and the extent of the rebuild that's required and the integrity of some of the structures that have been partially damaged, whether in fact we can rebuild from the partially damaged structure or partially retained structure, or whether we need to put it all down together. As you know, that we have a very short school term, school holidays I should say. It starts again next month in about 4 weeks time. So obviously there needs to be some quick solutions to accommodate the students when they come back.
See. Since most of the house, most of the people, they're facing a lot of difficulty, the food is wet, the clothes is wet. Any type of incentive help will be given to these people in the Northern Division?
Yeah, the Department of National Disaster Management, of course, is, the Ministry, I should say, is looking at those aspects. There will, of course, be assistance we provide. Some assistance has already been provided in certain areas. But like you said, a lot of these places, they want the utilities. Utilities is pretty important, as you saw over here. The catchment up there has been blocked. So as soon as they get water, and that's what they're saying, that once they get access to water, then they can start doing rebuild. A lot of people are quite keen to rebuild their homes on their own. Because they still have the material. As we've already seen that yesterday we went to Wendikoraway. A lot of people's roofs have been blown away. They eventually put them back up. But there are, of course, in certain areas where the agricultural production has been damaged. Like we went to a farm yesterday where the gentleman and those watermelons have all been damaged. There's also some of the areas, the sugarcane plantations have also been damaged. So it has an input, it has an effect on the output in the months down the track or even next year. So those are the considerations, of course, with the Minister of Agriculture here. With his team, they're doing the assessment, what type of assistance needs to be provided. There's some assistance that needs to be in the long term, others obviously needs to be some immediate assistance that needs to be done. But most definitely, of course, will be ensuring that the utilities actually get up fairly quickly, in particular water. And even if it means distribution of water, some of it we understand will be starting this afternoon itself too, in different parts of Manila.
So, just your overall observation since your arrival yesterday and today, what have you noticed about the people that have been affected by TC Yasa?
I think it's quite incredible. Some of the people, they're quite displaying a lot of resilience. A lot of people are saying, okay, we start rebuilding our homes again. Like we said, some people simply need access to water. Some people just are concerned about, for example, the agriculture, the farms, etc. So, you know, different people have different needs, but there's no doubt people have already started rebuilding on their own accord. You saw that when we were here, the New Zealand aircraft was flying very low. They're taking all the pictorial pictures, essentially carrying out a lot more damage assessments, in particular for those areas that we have to get to. It will also help in calculating overall the dollar value of loss. And what can be done, as you know, that the head of UN in Fiji is also here with us and seeing how we can coordinate with them, and they want to coordinate with us, of course, in respect of providing assistance. Yep, thanks.
This kid survived it.
So you where is your home? You stay in place, huh? So this is on Wednesday, Thursday. How are you?
Last time we
must have been thin flying with them. Were there things flying when you came on?
Yeah, things flying. We having a torch and we just tried to see if.
So where did you go?
We just came this side.
Oh. And you've been here all your life?
I'm married here. I came all the way from that side.
Oh yeah, the lemon tea.
Possible.
Oh. Yeah, but a lot of people are saying that they haven't experienced a cyclone
before. Yeah. Even me in my life, first time I've experienced this.
Which way did it come from? The way?
First, about 6 o'clock, it came this way.
In the evening?
Yeah, in the evening. 7 to 8, and I think then this way. I think.
Now, friend is best friend, Marta Vale.
Who's up in Club?
What's in the Evelyn?
I have to go to a number of other people.
This is I should take this to my office. Yeah?
Three, two, one, and one more.
The son went to school and the old lady was there. So the old man will get bring her here. Yeah. One more.
Yo, Bula, how are you? Were you at the school in the setting school?
Yeah.